Allah Jalla Ala forgive him of his sins. If it is for someone that is alive, you're asking, may Allah forgive him of his sins, the past one. And for those that he will fall into, may Allah allow him not to fall into this, those sins, fil mustaqbil. If he do fall into those, rahimakallah still mean that may Allah give him the tawfiq to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many people fall into sins and they don't repent? Huh? How many people, they barakallahu fikum, they fall into sins and they don't think about repenting? They might be going to club, they might be womanizing, they might be smoking dope, they might be doing this, doing that, drinking, drunk. It's no, they don't think about repenting. The only thing they will say is, well, I'm young, I got time. The malaika doesn't know who has time. Now you saying you got time. Malakul Maut, he doesn't know who has time. The time will be up, Allah Jalla wa Ala will command him to go pick this one up. And many times, barakallahu fikum, we come near death. But we do not learn from that. We think we can be just doing what we want to do. And put it on the tab of I'm young. I can do it. Alhamdulillah, the life of the individual, it is like a day after another after him. The days, they will alternate with you, on you. You leave one day, you are closer to your grave. Doesn't matter how young or how no gray hair you have, or it doesn't matter how much of a gray hair you have. So therefore, barakallahu fikum. The statement of rahimakallah for the individual that is alive. You say rahimakallah. You say, Abdullah rahimakallah, it means that may Allah forgive him of the sins that he has done. And for the sins that he will be about to do, may Allah protect him not doing it. If he does do it, that may Allah give him the tawfiq to repent from it. Right? Because at-ta'ibu li-dhanbi kama la dhanba lahu. The one that repent from a sin, it is as if he doesn't have no sin no more. So this is why it is incumbent upon all of us. From the shabab, la siyama from us, the gray hairs. Well, the gray hairs. I mean to say the dark hairs, I'm sorry. I'm too meant to say the dark hairs. La siyama from us, the dark hairs. Those, alhamdulillah, still young. We should not be looking as barakallah our affairs as being a play and amusement. Wallahi, the death will come to us anytime. Anytime. Any given situation. Am kuntum shuhada idh hadara Yaqub al-maut idh qala li banihi ma ta'buduna min ba'di. When Yaqub alayhi salatu wa salam, death, he was approaching him. He asked his children, who are you going to worship after me? They say, na'budu ilahaka wa ilaha aba'ika Ibrahim wa ishaqa wa Ismail wa ishaqa ilahan wahida. We will worship your Lord, the only Lord, the Lord of Ibrahim, the Lord of Ismail, the Lord of Ishaq. And we will be submissive to him. Imam al-Sa'id rahimahullah, he say, man aasha ala shay, mata alayhi. وَمَنْ مَاتَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ بُعِثَ عَلَيْهِ. Whoever is upon something, this is what you're going to die upon. If an individual, he all his life is party, believe it or not, this is how he will die. You might be taken out from the club, coming out, Fajr, getting out the club, and an 18-wheel come on your way, just right there, that's the end of your life. And you might have been drunk. Dead drunk, barakallahu fikum. That's the end of your life. Rahimahullahu rahmatan wasi'a, our brother. This, his life was to come for Fajr with his books. And this is, alhamdulillah, how he passed away. May Allah open all the doors of the Jannah for him, our brother, Baba, rahimahullahu ta'ala. This was his life. That's what it ended in, barakallahu fikum. For the individual, they want to take their life in the clubbing, and the smoking, and the womanizing. This is what your life is about. Now you're going to put it on the account, I'm a young man. 20 does not come twice in the life of a person. هكذا حجي 20 doesn't come twice. عاش برضه 20 does not come twice. You cannot be 20 two times in your life. فهمتوا؟ 20 will not come twice in one life. You can remember when you were 14, Abba Maryam. You can remember when you were 40, or you know, maybe working the whole field, your field, your father's field, your mother's field. Today you can't do it no more. Today you barely can just get up straight up from your seat. You might hesitate a little bit because you got few crack in your bones, few dent on your bones. 20 doesn't come twice. 18 doesn't come twice. So for us, the youth, we got to be serious about our religion. Not to follow those who are losers in this life and the hereafter. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. They are the losers. So he mentioned, بارك الله فيكم, Imam Ibn Kathir, رحمه الله, may Allah have mercy upon him. It means, he say, الْخَالِقُ لِهَذِهِ الْأَشْيَاءِ. He said, the one that created all these things. He's making reference of what? What was the reference he said? الخالق لهذه الأشياء. No, he mentioned الخالق لهذه الأشياء. The one that created all these things. The water, Allah, the heavens, the earth, and the nabat, and likewise the vegetation. The one that created all of this. He said, هو المستحق. He is the only one deserving. He say للعبادتي for the للعبادة for the worship. أسمع هذا لك؟
نعم.
أحسن الله إليك. طيب, he mentioned الخالق لهذه الأشياء, the one that created all of this. طيب, because remember the verse he talks about, الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم. So he, the one that created all of this, Imam Ibn Kathir رحمه الله, he say, he is the only one deserving to be worshipped. He say, وأنواع العبادة, and the Shaykh رحمه الله, he say, وأنواع العبادة التي أمر الله بها مثل الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان. And these are the types of worship like that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, the likes of al-Islam, the likes of al-Iman, and the likes of al-Ihsan. The likes of al-Islam, the likes of al-Iman, and the likes of al-Ihsan. These are the type of yani acts of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded. Shaykh Muhammad Aman al-Jami rahimahullah ta'ala, in his explanation, he say, commenting on the statement of Ibn Kathir first, he say, قال Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, الخالق لهذه الأشياء هو المستحق لعبادته. He say, يقر ما قلنا. He said, the one that created all of these issues, all of these things, he is the only one deserving to be worshipped. He said, this comes to confirm what we have said. And he said, listen to this. He said, هذا أسلوب القرآن. And this is the way of the Quran. Meaning the way of what? Calling the people. Calling the people to the ألوهية of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And he say, والاستدلال بالتوحيد الربوبية على توحيد الألوهية. taking the tawheed of ar-rububiyyah as evidence, as a must for the tawheed al-uluhiyyah. Unlike the tablighi. The tablighi, they will talk about rububiyyah all day, every day. But when it comes to uluhiyyah, they will never talk about this. And when you tell them this, they say, well, we should not be talking about shirk and tawheed, because it will segregate the people. It will divide the people. Faya subhanallah. Wasn't it the first thing that Allah commanded the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Wasn't it the reason why the people of Mecca made it very difficult upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba? Because they were calling upon tawheed and doing what? And preventing and warning against that which is shirk. So now the tablighi today, they say, no. That's not correct. The Messenger was not correct. Abu Bakr was not correct. This is what is they saying. Because if you say, no, we will not talk about tawheed or shirk. Because هذا يفرق بين المسلمين. This will be making a difference. This will segregate the Muslims. We ain't going to talk about this. Let's just talk about rububiyyah. Allah is al-Khaliq. Allah is al-Razzaq. Allah is al-Mudabbir. Allah is al-Muhyi, al-Mumit. Allah, mashallah, to the end of the line. But amma now, what is the wisdom behind establishing the rububiyyah of Allah? Except it is what? To use it as evidence for what? For the uluhiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why. Sometimes people find it very difficult to talk to the kuffar. Alaykum salam wa rahmatullah. But it is very easy. This is the uslub of the Quran. Bring about rububiyyah to establish the uluhiyyah. Very easy. Bring about the rububiyyah to barakallahu fikum, establish and affirm that which is what? Is the uluhiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to be bringing your own words, or want to look like you are intelligent, or you have intellect going on, or you got the going on. No, take it easy. Take the uslub of the Quran. Establish the rububiyyah to affirm what? The uluhiyyah. Easy. This same verse, barakallahu fikum, could be used to give da'wah to the kuffar. And to give da'wah to the Muslims also. To give da'wah to the Muslims that barakallahu fikum, they, those who ascribe themselves to Islam, but yet they are practicing shirk wa na'yadhu billah. Why you gotta go to the grave of Ahmad Bamba? Why do you gotta go to the grave of Al-Badawi? Why do you gotta go to the grave of Abdul Qadir al-Jailani? Why do you gotta go to the grave of Ahmad Bamba or Ahmed Tijan? Why do you gotta go to the grave of Fatima? Why do you gotta go to the grave of so and so? Why do you gotta do those? Is Fatima the one that created the heavens and the earth? The person will tell you no. Why do you gotta go to the grave of Ahmad Bamba? Is he the one that created, that make the rain fall? Is he the one that bring forth the rain? Why do you gotta go to the soothsayer? Is he the one that has his own risk? Is he the one that is controlling the flow of the air, the direction of the wind, or how much water is coming down? Is he the one that is controlling this? Everybody will agree to say no, only Allah. Then limadha, why do you need help from someone else that doesn't even can help himself? Why? Limadha tatlubu rizq bi ayyid al-faqir? Why is it that you are seeking provision from someone that doesn't have his provision? Right? And people will be bringing any tricks and phony things to barakallahu fikum, steal the aqidah of the people. This is why the Muslims, barakallahu fikum, they have to be awake. Knowing that there are people around us, people in the mix of the Muslims, dressing like us, talking like us, memorize the Quran, but yet, barakallahu fikum, they are deviant. Yet they are calling you to kufr and shirkiyat. They will tell you, if you take this shower that I'm going to give you, if you take this ring, if you put this ring I'm going to give you, then all the doors will be open. If you take this ring I'm going to give you, anybody that you want anything from them, just put the ring on and shake their hands. Whatever you ask them, they will give you. Where is barakallahu fikum, our Lord? وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِي. Simple. If my servant asks about me, I'm close. He didn't say I'm close. That's how close he is. He didn't say I'm close. So therefore, barakallah, and this is that which barakallah fikum. The majority of the Muslims today, they ignore the issue of tawheed. And this is our responsibility, أيها الإخوة, to understand.